Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. A major earthquake warning was in effect because of critical geometry, and we estimated a mid-7 magnitude 1 or 2 to occur in the previous week. If you look at the SSGI graph with the earthquakes magnitude 5.6 and larger projected on the graph, we see that a magnitude 7.5 occurred at Tonga on the 10th, pretty much at the time of the planetary peak that we see there in purple. And it was followed by a magnitude 5.9 at the southwestern Ryukyu Islands, Japan. And then with the next critical planetary geometry on the 13th and 14th, we see also a clustering of stronger earthquakes, and it just stayed below the 6 magnitude range up to magnitude 5.9. There was the potential for another major earthquake, but that did not happen following that planetary geometry. And then with the lunar peak on the 17th, that I also mentioned in the previous update, we see a magnitude 6.4 at Guatemala, and that happened yesterday night. So we see the relationship between the planetary geometry and the larger earthquakes again here on the SSGI graph. What to expect in the coming week? If we look at the SSGI graph for the coming week, we see a clustering of critical planetary geometry on the 20th and the 21st, and also lunar geometry, and that converges on the 20th and the 21st, and there is probably going to be a seismic increase into the higher 5 magnitude range, typically above magnitude 5.6, but there's also the possibility of a stronger seismic event potentially around the 22nd, give or take one day, could be mid 6, could be higher 6. That very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, the amount of stress between faults. We cannot measure that, so that is always an uncertainty. But if we look at that planetary geometry, it starts early on the 20th with Mercury, Mars and Uranus in a right angle, that's 90 degrees. That will be followed by a high lunar peak. Dotted lines means semi-right angles. A high peak means multiple semi-right angles. And indeed, with the Moon and Mars, and also the Moon and Jupiter, that's late on the 20th and early on the 21st, that can result in a mid to high 6 magnitude earthquake, especially because of the convergence with additional planetary geometry. The purple peak, Venus, Mercury and Saturn, is a conjunction late on the 20th, close to midnight, and that will be followed by another right angle, and that is Sun, Mercury and Venus. So as you can see, we're going to have quite a convergence of critical planetary and lunar geometry on the 20th and the 21st. And then we also see in the solar system this planetary geometry depicted. The right angles is the planetary geometry, and the green angles is the geometry involving the Moon. 90-degree angles, two of them converging, and also 90-degree angle with Mars and Jupiter, very nice depicted here. The Moon right in the middle, 245-degree angles, and then the 90-degree angles. As seen from Earth, this is actually geocentric with Mars and Jupiter. And also Venus, Mercury and Saturn in a conjunction. And then two 90-degree angles involving Mercury again. As seen from Mercury, a 90-degree angle with Mars and Uranus. And as seen from the Sun, that's heliocentric, a 90-degree angle with Mercury and Venus. So a lot is going to happen in the solar system on the 20th and the 21st. Again, an obvious seismic increase is likely to occur, at least into the high 5 magnitude range, approaching magnitude 6, but 1 or 2 6 magnitude earthquakes is definitely possible. Whether it is going to reach magnitude 7, that is the big question here. For now, I'd say mid to high 6 magnitude around the 22nd, following that planetary and lunar geometry. Stay safe. Until next time.